All right, Camille, I just got the power rankings from GN. Let me plop
All
this. Oh,
right.
whoa, God. that's the wrong one.
What's what?
Let's ignore
Whoa, whoa, what's that?
this. Boys,
Did we just?
real power ranking. Oh
That's
my
right.
goodness, here we
What
are
was
again.
that Duel Links dev mode?
That was
What the heck?
definitely a dev mode. So, Resonators and Automats tied this week for first place, but
Very, very interesting.
technically Automats takes first place because they won more first places. Thoughts? What do you think? Resonators won handedly last week, but this time Automats, they came back.
Most Resonator decks are now switching straight up to the Solemn Scolding build. We saw that at Worlds as
Nope.
well. And some successful lists using Volcanic Queen. I personally have not seen it. Have
No.
you
I've seen it a
heard
little
that?
bit, but it's really just
It
not working
sounds
out.
good in it sounds good, you know,
Yeah.
if you have like a leftover monster or whatever, but you
Yeah.
know,
I think the
it's honest.
idea is like the normal summon, right? But then it's like, oh man, the Volcanic Queen herself just isn't doing enough overall.
Right.
You know, like, okay, you're still giving them a huge monster that they're taking advantage of in a lot of these matchups. So I don't know.
Yeah, Resonators, I'm very surprised that they are second place over, you know, a deck like Gaia, which had, you know, almost identical participation to Resonators, but they just came up short so many times this week. I think that they are still seeing their weakness from not being able to, you know, generate momentum without a field spell. That's a huge crutch for the deck and one that many decks can just easily out. You know, so it leads to them being more vulnerable in later stages of the tournaments, not getting those high placements.
Pretty much.
Resonators, a little more safe. You know, they're not totally dependent on one card, and then they got double skill activation, come back from the grave, banish. You know,
Oh
it's
God.
so that
Well,
is what's keeping them in the rat race with Automats, I feel
yeah.
like.
And it's kind of funny because it's like a lot of the top players are like, oh, well, Resonators can be used as like an engine instead. So for example, today we had the $500 tournament and we saw someone running, he made top 64 because there were so many players. He made a Resonator Thunder Dragon deck. And it seemed cool when
Resonator Thunder Dragon.
it worked, it looked cool, but then he got 2-0'd in top 64, and then I was like, well, let's
Oh,
not talk about this anymore. So, just forget
just sweep that under the rug, you know?
that existed. Cyber Dragon, third place. That was like
Yes.
that's one of those decks that I feel like will just enter and exit the meta because it's just not consistent enough to be on the power rankings. But God,
Yeah.
I think it's one of
This
the
week it popped
worst
off.
feelings. Worst feeling in the world is getting Syndra OTK'd.
Yeah, just getting Syndra five card comboed, you know, Hell of Abyss, your boss monster, Fusion Gate. He's got the whole nine yards. We saw that happen at Worlds a lot. It was a valid option for a lot of people because in past KC Cups, it did perform very well. And it can perform very well for you too. But the thing is, you really have to learn how to play with as little resources as possible. That's really what comes down to it. With Cyber Dragon matches, they are finding any amount of way to access their graveyard and their, you know, banished monsters so they can fuse, you know, find the easiest avenue to fusion. So that's what you have to do to stop them.
The amount of Cyber Dragons I've seen lose because they early use their skill and then just they don't do anything afterwards is kind of insane. But I mean, that's why you see things like Drowning and Book of Moon. I think Zade King said it best. It is the deck where off a single top deck, they sack you. That's it. It's just this is the last card I needed for
One
Exodia.
of the few decks that can one card, you know, reverse sack you. Most decks, even on the power rankings, can't do that.
Nope. I literally saw someone do it to, after getting Black Rosed, he's still Cyber Dragon OTK'd. So feels bad. It does not feel good. You
Feels
talked a little
bad,
bit
bro.
about Gaia. I think Gaia, not too much to talk about there, right?
Yeah, nothing has changed for the deck itself, but you know, just unable to pick up these tournament placements, especially now that Resonators are competing on even ground with Automats. You know,
Pretty
Gaia
much.
does not have such a great matchup into either of those decks. It loses in the long game against those decks. It just does not have the resources to catch up without the field spell. And, you know, both those decks run MST, right? So a lot of the meta is really includes backward disruption. You know, you think Harpies, Onomats, Cyber Dragons, Resonators, they all destroy back row, and Gaia is relying on one back row right now. So they're standing based on their raw power and ability to just destroy things, quick effect destruction. But that's all they're hanging on by right now.
There you go. And then we have Thunder Dragons making fifth. Again, Thunder Dragons, another deck that's just in and out, high roll deck. A deck, funny enough, oldest deck in the metagame of relevant meta decks. This deck it came into the meta when Levianeer was launched, back when we had the Dark Magician and everything like that. It got nerfed for a little bit, and then it came back after they unnerfed it by bringing them, letting them play the Gold Sark and playing the Charge Light Brigade again by bringing back the Thunder Dragon Dark. This deck just doesn't go away. It randomly wins huge tournaments. This
specific deck list is very interesting. It does not play any hand traps, but I would say that Thunder Dragons do benefit from being able to put out Xyz monsters and have extreme survivability without back row. But you know, that does come at a huge disadvantage, because in this meta, you know, back row is the best way to disrupt a lot of these decks that, you know, need to chain summon, and Thunder Dragons, they do not do that. So their best avenue of play is making Xyz monsters to counter your opponent, get rid of their stuff. And they are very good at spamming Xyz monsters.
There you go. But, now
ends up coming up short a lot.
I know a lot of people will hate me if I don't bring it up, so we're going to talk about it, even though they did not make the top five. TG. Mm-hmm. Now, this is a deck that a lot of people are thinking might end up on the tier list, the DLM tier list, might end up on our tier list, may end up on, you know, we saw it at Worlds a whole bunch. TGs are 1 point away from the top five. They're right under Thunder Dragon, but with way more representation, so they didn't convert as well.
I see.
I personally believe that TG is an amazing deck when you go into like a KC Cup style format. I don't necessarily think it's as good in the side deck because of side decking things like Necro Valley and DD Crow and stuff like that. The meta decks can easily side into those, and that just destroys Tech Genus. And they always seem to struggle once they hit top cut. I don't know. It's definitely a strong rogue style deck, but I have not seen, at least from the streams I've watched, I've not seen enough info to be like, yeah, this is a tiered deck. I just think it was really, really, I think it's a tiered deck if we talk about like KC Cup format, but in side deck format, it's not really one that I would go to. Good deck, good rogue strategy, but not like meta defining, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think that it definitely has its own place. You know, there's no deck that is just, it's the mill graveyard spam effect of the meta, right?
Breakthrough skills. Previously,
they tried to get rid of them. You know, it's the kind of block. Previously, this deck, if you guys don't know, it is kind of a derivative, a version of the dinosaur block dragon mill deck that is using, you know, Survival Zen. Mm-hmm. It is just that plus TG, but, you know, Booster Raptor is a dino. So, hey, you have easy to grab dinosaur with Miscellaneousaurus, and you have this deck. And it's really mill dependent, so it's not reliable in itself, and you're really depending on TGs at the end of the day. So if you can get your TG combos off, you know, but at the end of the day, you're playing a 30 card deck, and this deck doesn't really run back row removal. So I don't know, you kind of just have to play in the back row if you don't go first.
Yeah. So, well, I mean, this upcoming week, assuming there's no ban list, a huge asterisk, you know, we don't know how the meta shifts.
Right.
I know there people have been playing more TG, so maybe the results will change, but just looking at the top cut, starting, this is the, today we our first tournament, this is the one that would go into the power rankings. TG's did not earn a bunch of points today. I like the TG deck, and I hope it becomes
meta. Me too, I do like it as well. It's really creative.
Yeah.
A lot of cool avenues for play there.
But as of right now, I would consider it a rogue tier strategy deck, not so much a tiered deck. And I know some people were bringing Blue Eyes to try and counter TG, but I don't think the game plan is to counter TG. I think TG will take care of itself.
TG is like anti-meta deck.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's what it is. You know, it's supposed to you know, be here to just quick effect destroy, you know, because that's something it has that a lot of the other decks, like, you know, Automats and Resonators don't have, that disruption during your opponent's turn. That's its main strength.
Yeah.
Just
definitely, you know, the deck to watch, though. That's my eye is on it for next week, because we'll see. That is pretty much it. As far as the meta goes, this will probably, fingers crossed, be the last power ranking under this format. Maybe?
Question mark? That's you're on some hopium, dude. I don't think we're getting something until after the KC Cup.
YouTube comments, clip and ship it.
We're not getting a balance after KC Cup.
Yeah, so probably, like, not.
3 weeks.
Hey, but new mini box, though.
Yeah, new mini box around the corner. We're going to have a new mini box review, breaking down the support. Yeah. You'll see how it does in tournaments.
Well, there you go.
When's our first tournament going to be? Tuesday?
I think Tuesday will be meta weekly, so probably Wednesday.
Yeah,
I think. Okay. Yeah, something like that.
Right.
But yeah, there you go. Well, guys, we'll see you next week. Kamel, what can they do to help support DLE?
Guys, well, first of all, you can enter 6 tournaments a week by joining the Discord for free. And in there, we have free new player help. Joining the Discord's free. The tournaments are free. And if you want, you can enter some higher prize pool tournaments like the GG Tour tournament that Rob was mentioning earlier.
There you go.
Huge, huge money.
And Battlestep. Right. If we don't have a sponsor, GG Tour, so at least $75. There's always one high prize pool tournament per week at DLE. There you go.
That's right.
All right, boys, for me, from Kamel, take it easy. I hope the mini box changes the metagame. Ban list will happen. Quote me. If not, flame me in the comments, dude. See you later.
Peace out.